some kind of energies, intense heat in the center of the Great Pyramid,
mm-hmm.
okay, in the King's Chamber.
Mm-hmm.
And I love this because, you know, I like the fact, you know, you can actually, you know, there's evidence, physical evidence, that this thing was definitely a machine,
mm-hmm.
okay? And I outline the evidence for this, you know, the fact that there was soot on the walls and it smelt horrible.
Mm-hmm.
And I talk about, you know, the evidence of state-of-the-art machine tooling and all the information that makes you think that this thing was definitely a machine, okay?
Yeah, yeah.
But this, and then I say, well, that's obvious then. Pyramid in Greek means fire in the middle.
There you go,
right?
Yeah, yeah.
So the pyramid had a fire in the middle. Now, what I say is that when you put focus energy in a five-cornered resonant crystal, that creates an etheric double.
Hmm.
So the pyramid was converted into an octahedron.
Interesting. Okay, so the octahedron appears energetically then, I guess.
Energetically.
Hmm.
And then that structure then becomes a stabilizing force.
Ah,
and I say that the pyramid was deliberately placed in the center of the landmass. And I explain it in the book, and I say that, you know, that there's a reason for that, and the clues are there, you know, there's definitely clues. And
indeed.
I feel that there was something going on with that pyramid, that it was actually there, it was designed to communicate with the center of the earth.
Yeah, balancing,
which is
right.
Also another octahedron structure.
Hmm.
And I believe that the core of the earth communicated out to the galaxy.
Hmm. Communication there, yeah.
And I felt it was a communication tool.
Mm.
And I feel that the pyramid now is defunct.
Mm-hmm.
And that I'm telling people that they have to recalibrate, they have to become balanced, and then use that empowerment to work with the earth. I think it's very important that we have to create that role that the pyramid did before.
Mm.
And we have to send balanced energies down to the core of the earth and literally reprogram the core of earth, and then there are mechanisms, let's say,
mm-hmm.
for that information to be sent out into the galaxy.
So we don't have to go out and build something, because this is more a spiritual connection than a physical material connection, I guess.
That's what I feel, and I talk about at the end of my book. I feel that as part of our evolutionary progress, humans have to take more responsibility.
Helping balance the earth also, then, I guess.
Yeah, and again, I talk about the, at the beginning, near the beginning of the book, I talk about the, what's happening is that with this, the plasma entities, we'll go back to this now, they had a function of working with the earth and maintaining stability, but there's been a changing of the guard. So old energy has been leaving the planet and new energy has been coming in, but there's a change in the balance. And so humans have to take more responsibility for what's going on this planet.
To round things off, I'm curious. I just wanted to ask you, and you can answer it if you want or not. But are you receiving channeled messages, or is this a group that you're part of that you meditate?
Okay. This is an interesting question.
Mm.
I do believe I have guidance, but I don't channel.
Okay.
When I talk about channeling, over the years I've been picking up certain books. I like the Barbara Marcinek books with the Palladian channeling. I think that's very valid information.
Mm-hmm.
Kryon books, there's about 12 books now. Lee Carroll, who channels Kryon, he's been invited to the United Nations. There's a spiritual group that meets at the United Nations. He's been invited 6 times, and I think that information is mostly very good information.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very fussy about the information I pay attention to, quite frankly.
Mm-hmm.
And so there's a Seth material, I feel, that was channeled through Jane Roberts. This is highly regarded metaphysical information, highly regarded, and I quote some of that in my book as well.
Oh, okay.
So I do pay attention to some of it, but a lot of it I don't pay any attention to at all.
Okay.
And I don't channel myself.
Okay. That's very interesting to hear, because it's always intriguing to hear what, you know, when this comes up now and then, as it does, and ask people what it is and what they think that they do actually receive, you know, information from and by whom and so forth. But thank you very much for sharing that. And yeah. I think that would be a great place to kind of round things off for today, Susan. But again, let me say thank you so much for coming on. This has been a pleasure to have you on. But before we go, I really want to give you again the opportunity to mention your book and your website, of course.
Yeah. The website that's a sort of built to support the book, and it's the background information, that is www.joyfirepublishing.com. And then the other website, which is my older website, is susanrenison.com. So that's www.susanrenison.com. And that's more my older articles and my current blog that I'm doing. There's a lot of free information. If you read everything on two websites, you would get a lot of my book.
Mm.
But I do recommend that you get hold of the book, because the book is quite special and it has very good information. And if you're a teacher and you're interested in these spiritual concepts and the science, then the book is absolutely worth its weight in gold. I feel that I was directed to find this information, put this together, and I feel it would be very good for spiritual teachers or anybody that actually wants to understand what's going on this planet. I think the book would be very useful to have.
Indeed, very interesting perspective. And again, thank you so much for coming on and sharing it with us. Everybody, do check it out, susanrenison.com, for much more. And I hope we can do this again sometime, Susan. Thank you so much for coming
That's
on.
That's great. Thank you. Thank you for inviting me. Thank you.
Thank you. Your support and help is what keeps us going, so huge thanks to you for being a subscriber.
Thank you.